if you want it bad enough, you have to make a reality. And like hard work was something that I knew. That's the only thing I knew growing up. So it's like, if I have to work hard to make this real, I'm gonna do it. And that's what it turned into. It was like no sleep, like bad diet, it was everything, but it's been worth it. Like I feel more open, more free. Like where I am now, I couldn't be happier. We grew up pretty poor. So my dad, being from a third world country, we just didn't have a lot of money. So my mom had to sort of bear the financial burden, which made it so she didn't have a lot of time to nurture and teach. So ways of coming over that, I would say it was nice because we had a lot of freedom, but we didn't have any guidance. So it was figuring out my own path the entire time from the beginning. When I started 10th grade, I was working construction actually. So I'd get off from school and I would go do a construction job in the evening. I just knew it was what I should be doing. And you know, my brother was doing it, you know, some of my older brothers were. So we were used to that. We were used to like working hard. It felt like my life was planned for me already because growing up and, you know, working in the labor force, where it seemed like that's what I was supposed to do, or at least that's what other people thought I was supposed to do. So it seemed like I was getting stuck, you know? So it was just figuring out how to get out of that, to do what I want to do, at least have the option to do what I want to do. In high school, I was actually studying ceramics on the side as well. And then when I graduated high school, I bought a kiln and a wheel because I worked so much and I had money. So I just set up this thing which was going to be something on the side for me the whole time. I never anticipated it to come into like focus in my life. It was always like on the side or like pushed over. So it was actually crazy. So I was doing, you know, engineering work and doing, you know, Calc 2 and all this crazy stuff. But on the weekends, when I had time, I'd drive home to my parents' house where I had a studio, and I'd be doing ceramics there in between like my rigorous mathematics courses and stuff. So at some point it just felt like, if you could do anything, what would you want to do? And that's where it turned into like, I would love to just be in the studio all the time, like getting to focus on a vision, you know, on a work, you know, on making something instead of doing math. It just wasn't my thing at the time, and realizing that was such a big step for me. I mean, finances is like the biggest thing, and like it always is. And that was like the most terrifying thing for me, is that like, you know, will this make me money? And that's something when I made the call and then I did switch over to art, that was the thing I struggled with, staying in school the most. Because you have a degree that isn't necessarily going to get you a job outside of school, isn't going to make you money necessarily, and then like sticking with it still somehow. And like just being convinced that like you have to be so convinced in yourself that you're going to make it, that there's no question anymore. Once you meet me and like see what I do, I think you start to believe in the vision a little bit more. Because just like the fact that I'm, you know, here and making this work and doing this from where I've been and, you know, who I am, like you don't see a lot of like Honduran people making art really. You don't, you know, see a lot of people who grew up poor who are making art. That's just, it's not a thing that's very common. There's no situation where you have to follow through with this. If you don't want to do that, you don't have to. You know, our lifespan is like super short, so it's, what do you actually want to do when you're here? And I think that's one of the hardest questions to actually like fully say and evaluate. You know, who am I and who do I want to be?